Are you a corporation in need of coaching and training?
A church or a nonprofit that's seeking speakers, coaching, or training services?
Conference organizer in need of a keynote speaker?
Or a couple seeking relationship, premarital, or marital counseling or coaching?
Great. You're a part of our C Factor. That Life is a faith-based firm that provides speaking, coaching, training, and consultant services.
Are you ready to be about that life?
That Life specializes in helping individuals and organizations create transformational shifts that help them transition from caterpillars to beautiful butterflies.
And we're looking to connect with decision makers who are booking upcoming retreats, conferences, or trainings.
We are also available for group or one-on-one coaching and consultant services.
Please contact us for a free consultation at livethatlifenow@gmail.com. And remember to live that life now.
Hey, man. Sometimes it takes the bad days to appreciate the good ones. But no matter what, but you just keep winning. Just keep winning. Just keep winning. Winning.
Have you ever felt like you couldn't make it? Welcome to That Life Podcast, where we discuss love and relationships, spirituality and faith, career and education, pop culture, and everything in between. We give our take on it all as we navigate the path to living that life.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Welcome. I'm excited to be back.
Yes, this is our, what is it, our intro, our bonus?
I think it's just a bonus sneak peek episode. We miss you guys. We just wanted to talk to you and, you know, let you know what we've been up to.
We are so excited about the second season coming.
Yes.
In October. We are so excited. So we hope that for those of you who have not heard our episodes for season one, go back.
This is the time. Go back and catch up.
We're hot. We're coming in hot. We're ready for season two.
We may have to add that song. I mean, again, like on our season one wrap-up show, we talked about how everyone loves I Got That Remix by Anthony Brown and Group Therapy. We still love it. As you can see, we're still using it. But yeah, we may have to add Coming In Hot. That song has some special meaning to us now. We'll probably talk about that later in the season.
Yeah, so. even let's tell listeners, because some people have never heard that song and they get that like 30 seconds of our intro and outro.
I got that?
Yeah.
The remix. I always make sure to say it's the remix.
But the words are so important to us. And let's just share with them, since you brought it up a minute, why it's so important, because it's... The beat is awesome, first of all.
Yeah.
I mean, we love Anthony Brown and Group Therapy, period. I mean, we just love the part of Group Therapy. But also, the words are powerful. Mm-hmm. Every time we look up, we want to see you win it.
Yeah, and that's our truth.
That's our truth.
That is what that life is about, right?
Yes.
Living that transform, heal, affirm, triumphant life. That's the goal for all of us. We want to see you winning.
Yes, and for us... Even if people that we coach, counsel, deal with don't get it, we do it through prayer.
Yes.
We believe in prayer. We have called people
randomly
and just had conversations with them, checked in and said, do you mind if we pray for you?
Yeah, we really do try to be obedient and we try to move as the Spirit gives us utterance. So if we call you randomly...
Yes.
You know, that means God placed you in our hearts.
Hey, if you're looking...
And we're going to call you.
If you're looking for a personal uplift, because this is just what we do, you know, find us, get us, email us, and, you know, you never know.
Yeah.
You may get a random call from us, and we pray, and we praise, and we party. And we got an episode coming about that.
We have an episode about that, about balance.
Yes.
Yeah. It's good. So we do. We enjoy. You mentioned the email, livethatlifenow@gmail.com.
Yeah.
We enjoy hearing from you guys via email, hearing your thoughts on our shows when shows air. We have some people that will email us.
Yes.
And say, you know, I love that part about this and here are my thoughts about this, or with show topic ideas.
Yes.
We're always open to that. You know, we did towards the end of last season. We listened to your feedback. We were able to include some shows based on some of the things that you guys asked us to talk about. Yes. And we're doing that in the next season, too.
So get it in now as we are already recording.
As we're prepping and planning and recording for next season. About it,
but we love your input.
We do. So during the few months off, we had a break.
Yeah.
Gave us a chance to, we thought we would like recoup and, you know, like have a minute to just kind of like regroup, get a little rest. Because we knew we had some other things going on, a lot of things, a lot of personal things.
COVID would be gone.
We thought COVID would be
so
gone.
So we thought we would be on a plane somewhere, so, and that didn't happen.
Yeah. But we stayed really busy. We did a lot over this break.
Yeah.
And, you know, let's Hiram surprised me with a couple of road trips because, again, he knows we both love to travel, and that hasn't been something we've been able to do, not travel in the way that we like to travel.
But we did get some getaways.
So we did some getaways, which were really nice. They were a surprise for me. Yes. I enjoyed them. There's one thing about us, I would say, we love to just be active.
Yes.
Like, we like to do things that, you know, we can just get out together. It doesn't have to be anything major. We do big things, but, you know, small things.
Those little things.
It's the little things that we love.
Netflix and chill.
We love that. But we got out this summer and we did some festivals.
Yes.
You know, in the neighborhood, we kind of went out and did, you know, they have those summer festivals. We did some of those, which I really enjoy.
Right. We did those.
We did that. We did, you know, a bigger one, a really big one. That I hadn't been to in a long time. Enjoy that because it gives you that carnival feel, too. We did local ones. We actually did places, you know, in our community, not too far, where we said, let's just go out and just, you know, visit their downtown area.
Yep.
Let's just walk and do that.
We ate at Mom Paula's shops. We believe in the big restaurants.
Uh-huh.
But at the same time, we believe in contributing to the small restaurants.
Yep, that was fun.
In the neighborhood. We did tubing.
We did. We did river tubing.
Yes, that was.
Yep.
Oh, that was so serene.
So relaxing.
Yes.
We were on the river, on the DuPage River.
Yeah.
For 3 hours, I think.
Yeah, 3.5 to 4 hours. We packed a lunch.
It was nice.
Yes, romantic, serene. We prayed on the water.
We did.
It was awesome. We spent some time in the gym.
We did. We did a lot of time in the gym. We did a lot of walking.
Yes.
We did a lot of outdoor exercise during the break. That was good. But then we also worked. I mean, we did a lot of things. We weren't, you know, recording the podcast, so we did our motivational speaking.
Yeah, we had some engagements.
Yeah, which is something that, you know,
together,
we love to do. So we did that. One that sticks out to me, you always talk about, you guys know from listening, I am a gardener.
Yes.
And so we use the analogy of a gardener.
Yes.
With planting seeds and, you know, harvest and things like that. Won't get too much into it, but that was really good.
Yeah.
And that one was really important too, because that one was motivational speaking to a group of people that really serve the community.
Right. Right.
You know,
professional social workers, teachers.
Yes.
And we went in to motivate them and demonstrated by the analogy of seeds, how they, their words, mm-hmm. their actions are planting seeds
for the next
our
generation.
Youth. Yes. And we even inspired them by their stories and their victories and their testimonies,
the success stories that they have. You know, because sometimes we get so busy and we're so focused on what's next or what we haven't accomplished. Sometimes we really have to stop and look back at those things that we've already accomplished, because those can be a reminder. You know, when you see, in their case, the success stories of people that have come through their organization and now families have been transformed and they're thriving. Sometimes you have to look at those as a reminder to motivate you, to give you that push, you know, to remind you that this is why we do what we do. We're literally planting seeds.
Especially in a time like this.
Yeah.
You know, we're living in a time where, you know, people are trying to get back into school and back into office. And, you know, we'll talk about this season, the anxiety of that. But
that's
also
one of our shows.
The anxiety of, I don't want to go.
Right.
Because of the COVID and because of the pandemic. So people are having mixed feelings, but the issue is people are having cognitive, emotional issues dealing with a lot.
Yeah. So, of course, you know, you mentioned the trainings. Mm-hmm. We did develop some trainings over the summer. Let's talk a little bit about that.
We developed some trainings. We did, and we have a podcast about it, but we also have a training on stereotypes, prejudice, and discrimination.
That was one of our most talked about episodes.
It was.
You know, I just think it resonated with a lot of people. We got a lot of feedback on that episode. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, that's one that it's emotional, you know, for almost everyone who listens to it, because you can relate in some type of way, even if you're just watching it on the news.
Yeah. And, you know? And even with that, we've developed a training called The Transformation Must Come.
Yep.
Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion, DEI. And so, you know, this is something we do in businesses and organizations. And you look, we just talked to a company this week.
Yep.
And they don't even have a DEI program.
No, they don't have anything. And it's, you know, it's almost shocking in a time like this when everyone's trying to really embrace and really learn and be aware. It's almost shocking. But you know what? That's exactly why people like us are here. Just to, you know, bring awareness and start the conversation. And so we're happy to do that for organizations, for our listeners, for anyone who wants to have the conversation. That, you know, we also did a training. That reminds me of a training that we developed about anti-bullying.
Yes.
Because a lot of times when people are bullies, they are bullying people because they're different in some type of way.
Yes.
And that's why a transformation must come.
Yeah.
We have to learn to be more inclusive of others, you know, and welcoming and loving. And so to me, those go hand in hand, because the bullying is usually a result. It's usually, you know, it comes from people bullying someone that it has some sort of difference. Yeah. And we're all different.
And that's a base, you know, of our conflict resolution. But I also love the one about in living color.
Oh, my God. You know what? That one, in living color, microaggressions,
yes,
is what it's called. But just from doing this podcast and, you know, being out talking, motivational speaking, listening to people that have listened to our podcast and things like that, I am more now, you know, we talk about microaggressions. We touched on it a little bit in the stereotypes, prejudice and discrimination episode.
Right.
But it's like microaggressions. Now I'm looking at macroaggressions. Because some of these things are not microaggressions. They are blatant,
big,
bold, in your face. So they're really macroaggressions.
Yeah.
So that's something we'll probably have to talk about.
But I love the part and how we bring it out in living color.
I love it.
It is big. So those are
just some
things,
of the,
but
the trainings.
One of the things that I've kind of pushed, drafted my co-host on is, of course, you all know that I do counseling and I do a lot of premarital,
yeah,
and marital counseling, among other things. But I've added her on to,
yeah,
our counseling and
coaching
our course.
Services.
Yes, it's really a
it's an
a
actual
counseling
course.
Coaching course.
It's a course.
Yes, it's a course we put together, and we did a couple last year. Started in December of 2020, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we had sessions, they had homework, they
love
did
them.
Things. We met together, we met separate, we met with just him, with just her. It was really exciting. And then they got married.
Yeah.
That was like, when you do this, especially the premarital counseling, it's like marriage is the graduation.
Yeah.
It was so emotional.
It was so beautiful.
Yes, everybody was crying. The best man, the maid of honor, the groom. People were crying before the bride,
yeah,
even came out.
It was beautiful.
But that's another thing we do. We do officiate.
Yeah. We, you know, we love love.
Yes.
You know, and we're all about love and magnifying love. God is love. We're all,
yes,
about it. We're all about healthy,
well, about
love
kingdom
and kingdom
marriages.
Building kingdom marriages.
Yes.
That is our, you know, our goal. That's something we're really passionate about.
Yes.
Is not just marriage, but kingdom marriages the way God intended.
Yes.
And so, you know, we've really dug into that. We have, that has really grown.
Yes.
And
it
couples.
Is far. People will call for counseling and people have asked us, and it was like, well, is it 8 sessions? Is it 3 sessions? Is it this? And I tell people, we can't do it. We don't do. We're not
we don't
the
do
people.
A cookie cutter.
We can't do that. We meet people where they are. We meet,
yeah,
couples where they are. And it's a lot of things going on. I mean, we have a couple now that's a blended family. And that's,
yeah,
a little more work.
It is.
It's beautiful, but that's going to be more time than the other couple that was a younger couple.
And
that
we do things differently. You know, this has grown so much, the counseling and coaching, the course.
Yes.
You know, we literally have a course where we have materials, like you said, homework,
videos.
Assignments, videos, things that you have to watch, listen to. It's really growing. We are continuing to work on it and refine it, of course. We've had people ask for our help and just want tools. So we're also looking to maybe do something else. You know, we can discuss later, maybe like a subscription service where if you're not doing the counseling coaching, we have some things for you too.
Yeah.
So it's really growing. And the part I love about it is, like you said, the officiant services. That's something that has really grown. We're really excited about doing that because we offer, you know, we literally curate a custom wedding ceremony, because anyone who knows us knows we just don't do
very
things
non-traditional
the way that everyone else does them.
Yes, and that's in our coaching and counseling. That's what we tell our couples.
We encourage them.
You are not the Huxtables.
No,
you're not your mom and dad.
No,
you're not the people down the street.
No, you're
you. Unique.
Yeah,
and everything and about you from it. Your ceremony should be unique.
Exactly. So we're excited about that. You know, I'm all about kingdom marriages and doing what we can to build families, and you know, so that's one of our passions.
Yeah.
My other passion,
but I want to make sure people know another thing we're currently working on is the couples retreat.
Yes.
From
March 2022.
Yeah, we're
yes
currently working on that. Information will be out. So please, please, please. And it's limited. We can only do so many couples because we want it to be intimate. So if it's something you want to do, when we put the link out there, when we put the information out there,
we
recommend you sign up quick because we already know it's going to go fast.
We have some surprises for this retreat.
It's going to be like a 3-day getaway.
Yep.
You know.
We have stuff planned. It's going to be nice. But most importantly, we're going to have conversations.
Yes.
You know, the way we do on this podcast, we're going to give tools.
Yep.
You're going to spend a weekend with us.
Yep.
And we're going to have fun because, again, we're about balance.
We're going
like you talked about.
Pray.
Pray, praise.
We're going to praise.
Party.
We're going to team build.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're going to get some dancing in.
It's going to be
an exciting weekend, you know, for you and your boo.
Yeah. We're going to build some kingdom marriages. We're going to strengthen some kingdom marriages. You know, we want to, you know, reignite the flame.
Yes.
Where it's needed, you know, and
if it's
excited,
already hot,
hey,
we're just going to throw a little oil on it and make it even hotter. So
yes.
I'm very excited about that. Now, you are excited about our iron sharpens iron.
The love building and the kingdom marriages and, you know, these couples. That is one of my passions. The other is iron sharpens iron. We haven't done one in a few months.
Right. We're looking to do November.
Maybe November. We'll do another iron sharpens iron course because I love it.
Yeah.
You know, we've gotten such positive feedback on our iron sharpens iron. And it really is just what it says. You know, it really sharpens. It sharpens us.
Yeah.
It sharpens the people in the course. So I'm excited about that.
We're unique, not a cookie cutter. We take scriptures and we come from books. And like one we did, I'll say, the book of Ruth. We went through the whole book of Ruth.
Mm-hmm.
We meet with our participants every week.
Yep.
Again, they have homework and they have stuff, but every week we come. And what is important, it's really built about those that's in ministry, in prayer ministry, or Sunday school teachers, ministers, associate ministers, or apostles, or however. And we get into the word and find messages that relates to this generation, to this people today.
Yes.
And people are really excited. It's the same Bible, but, you know, we use a magnifying glass. And it's iron sharpened iron. It's not just us, but all of us are speaking and talking and finding things. And it's spirit-filled. It's exciting, and it's grand. So, again, when we put that out there, if you're interested, because it's, again, a small group, you know, first come, first serve, you know, we want you to get into that too. I love getting into the word. It is exciting every week.
I do too. And a scripture that I have loved for years is it's in the 119th Psalm. And it basically says, like, open my eyes that I may see wonderful things. One translation says, in your word. Mm-hmm. And that has been my prayer. I think I remember maybe as far back as 10 years ago, really, like, that scripture really resonated with me, because that would be, I would always make that a part of my prayer. Open my eyes that I may see wonderful things in your, it says in your law. One translation says, in your word. And I think that's what we do with Iron Sharpens Iron. We're literally just, like you said, it's the same Bible.
Yeah.
But we are opening the eyes,
yes,
of these leaders that they may see wonderful new things in the word.
Right.
So that they can deliver it in a way that is relevant,
yes,
to a, you know, a group of believers and non-believers today. Because that is the thing. We have to, it has to be relevant.
And it has to be exciting.
It has to be exciting.
The word of God,
you want a fresh
is
take
exciting.
On it. It is exciting.
I love praise and worship. I do.
Too.
I love the Sunday morning messages.
Oh, yeah.
But my favorite has always been Bible class.
Yes.
I love Bible class. I yes. love, because when you can feel the presence
yes.
of the great I am.
Yes.
In Bible class or even Sunday school, yes. it is like a whim. No music, no drums, nobody mm-hmm. singing, nobody yeah. Priming you, pumping you. But you can just get excited on the word. And that's what our yeah. Iron Sharpened Iron is about. Getting excited just over the word.
Yes.
And trust me, people have been excited.
We've had a great time where yeah. the course has ended and people are like, I'm
more,
sad.
More,
I don't
more,
want this
more.
To end. And we're like, we don't either. So we're going to get back into that.
And the whole goal is for you, the listeners, or the people that's in the class, is to go and preach the word, to do the 10th chapter of Matthew, mm-hmm. to teach, heal, and prophesy, to deliver a people in the same word, but in an exciting, revelating, yes. revealed way.
Yes. So. No, it's, I love it. I'm happy. We have a lot going on. Yeah, things that, you know, maybe during the season we'll be able to share, or towards the end of the season, we have some exciting announcements and
yeah.
things like that.
Oh, yeah, we still, yes.
You know, that's
things.
Coming up.
Yes.
We're going to also try to do better with social media and with our YouTube. You know, maybe during the course of this season, you'll see us start to, you know, add more things to social media. We'll try to do that. Just to give you, you know, some sneak peeks and kind of inside looks. And, you know, we love, especially me, more so than Hiram, I love this platform where you just hear us and we can talk to you. I love it. But we are going to start.
Yeah, some people have never even seen us.
Yeah. And I love it. I think this is intimate.
I do.
But I think we're going to really start to put some things out there a little more on our social media platforms. So we're going to get busy with that. We're going to work on that. And like I said, we have just some exciting things coming up. Even just all the things we, you know, we talked to you guys about. But we still yet have some more things that we're excited about that's coming up, and we'll
yeah.
talk about that later.
We have some exciting topics already.
Exciting topics.
The episodes this year, we have one of my favorite, and I think we had to make that a part two.
Yep.
It was deep, but it talked about expired relationships.
Oh, that's a heavy one.
In your words, expired seasons.
Oh yeah, you know I'm big on that.
That's
one of maybe like you said, two episodes.
Yeah, that's
it. Covers
be two
episodes. We're talking about the ministry of no.
Yes. Can you say no? No.
No.
No. No.
Get
and I love we call it a ministry, but there's power in the word no.
There is.
And we go over that and teach you points on when, where, and how to use no and yep. still be okay with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You talked a little bit about the three P's, which is basically just balance. It's really about the way we live our lives, meaning we have no regrets. We are all about God. We are all about people, serving people, doing the work that God has for us. But we're about, you know, having fun too.
Yes.
And enjoying. Yes.
And that if you know us and people that know us, they know we could, at the same time, we could praise, we could pray,
yeah,
and we could dance like David.
Exactly.
So that's exciting. And we want people, I mean, that's what I think, live that life now.
That's what it
that's
means.
That's what we want people to
it
do and understand.
It means living the abundant life. So we're going to talk about that a little bit. We're going to talk about some, you know, issues that we feel are really needed. Anxiety, for instance, is one.
Yeah.
You mentioned that a little bit earlier. So we're going to talk about that. You know, we have some guests.
Yes, we have more guests this season, yeah, than we had last time. So we're excited about
that. So just a lot, you know. We just wanted to pop in, talk to you, tell you guys what we've been up to. For people that know Hiram personally, you know that he's a person that likes to go and do and explore. But he is really not about that theme park life. Like, he will go. He will go. And, you know, he goes, he will enjoy. He's really not about doing those rides and all of that.
Well, people
but
know that.
This summer, he was out there. He
I
did
was
it.
Up there.
He did a thing.
I was up there.
Yes.
Going so, round and round, back and forth, fast and slow.
So those types of things.
Ooh, love will make you do some things.
We had a good time. So, yeah, we did take some time. We were busy. We were working. But we had some time to enjoy ourselves and sort of, you know, regroup. We just, you know, had a big something that we celebrated very recently. We'll talk a bit, little bit about that later.
Yeah, we have a lot of things that's percolating.
Yeah.
So, you know, again, we're not going to hold you. This was just kind of a prelude to what's coming, a sneak preview. We are excited to be back in the studio for season 2. So get ready and let us go live that life now.
Well, that wraps up another episode. Thank you for being about that life, that transformed, healed, affirmed, triumphant life. Go win and meet us here next week for another episode. Live that life now.
But no matter what, but you just keep winning. Just keep winning. Just keep winning. 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 To every winner, every champion, every overcomer. This
song. I'm about that life. If you want to be about that life, connect with us on social media. Like and follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Live That Life Now, on Twitter at Live That Life 20, and at YouTube That Life. Contact us via inbox, DM, or email at livethatlifenow@gmail.com with feedback or show topic ideas.
Every time we look up, we want to see you winning.
Live that life now.